Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making corned beef sandwiches. And before you get the wrong idea about the corned beef, I'm using the kind that comes in a can. I've had some people occasionally ask, what can you do with that? Because it's very obvious in your grocery store, but not many people actually use it in their cooking. I have before in Betty's Kitchen, and this time I thought I would do some sandwiches, quick, easy summer meal. So I need to get this opened, and I want to show you what it looks like because I have chilled it in order for any fat to congeal at the sides, and then I can scrape that off with a knife and not have such a fatty version of corned beef. So I'll be back in a minute. Here I have my corned beef, and I have scraped all of the fat and discarded it. And you can see this is a much neater look to a can of corned beef. Now what I need to do is shred it. So I'm just going to take two forks and just pull it apart and come out with little chunks of corned beef to make our sandwiches. Here's what our can of corned beef looks like after you have shredded it. It should be separated pretty well by now. Now this was a 12-ounce can. If some of you are thinking about using corned beef that you get from the deli, you'll have to have a way of grinding it or chopping it very finely in order to have the same effect that we're going to have in these sandwiches. But this works perfectly if you don't mind using canned corned beef. To this can of corned beef, we're going to add 1 cup of finely shredded sharp cheddar cheese. We're also going to add some olives, and you could use ripe olives, which is what I'm doing here. This is 1/4 cup chopped, finely chopped, ripe olives. If you prefer the salad olives, you could use those. 1/4 cup. The salad olives are the green olives that have pimentos for stuffing. And then I have 1/2 cup of mayonnaise. And the last ingredient is 1 tablespoon of Worcestershire sauce. Now I can see that this is overrunning my bowl, so I'm going to put this in a different bowl, something a little bit bigger, so I can stir it up, and I'll come back with the stirred up. I have my corned beef mixture all mixed together, and you'll notice that I flattened it a little bit around the bottom of this bowl, and I have divided it into 4 sections. The reason I did that is that this is enough mixture to do 8 buns worth. We're putting these on buns, like hamburger buns. So if you could get 1/8, that would be dividing one of these in half, or one of this, or this, or this. So I could use any one of those pie-shaped scoops and put that on a bun, and that would be the filling for 1 bun. So I'm going to show you the bread that I have. Here we have some buns. These are healthy, live, and they do have some good qualities about them. They're not whole wheat, but they are wheat buns, so they do have some of the whole wheat in it, and they are 99% fat-free, and they're low in calories, so that was the reason for choosing them. What I need to do is to use the bottom bun and place this mixture on it and spread it out. Just spread it toward the edges. And then put the top on. And you'll see I have it sitting on aluminum foil. And what I'm going to do is turn that upside down and bring this foil in from this end and this end, and then just enclose it. If you want to go like this and bring it up, that's fine. And then put it in a pan. And there would be 8 of these all together that will be baked in the oven. Now, Rick and I are going to have lunch after a while, and we just decided we wanted 1 each. And have it along with some salad that we have. So I'm using a small Pyrex dish and placing that in there. So I have 1 more to go. that I will place in there, and then we'll bake these in a 375 degree oven, and they will bake for 18 to 20 minutes. I've just gotten our corned beef sandwiches out of the oven, and they were at 375 degrees for 18 minutes, so I feel sure that they're done, not overly so. Now they're hot, but you need to remove from the plate they were cooked in over to your serving plate and unwrap while it's still hot. I think I'll flip this over so I can get it out from the bottom and then over again onto the serving plate. This is what it looks like. This has turned a little bit crusty, and if I cut it down the center, it's very soft inside because it has the cheese melted and the corned beef has cooked down. So there's the sandwich that we have. And I'll be back to take a bite of this in just a second. I'm going to take a bite for you, and I've filled in my plate with some fresh flat-leaf parsley from the garden. And this is the upload that we did recently of favorite carrot salad. And here is today's upload. This is our corned beef sandwich, and it's baked in the oven, wrapped in foil, has all those goodies inside it. So I'm going to see what it tastes like. First thing I get is nice and salty, which corned beef is. Tastes really good. Going back for more. This bun is just a little bit sweet against the salty corned beef, and then the cheesiness in there. All of those flavors blend together so well. And I think it will go well with our salad here. I'm not going to take any of that right now because I've already shown you a bite of that in a previous upload. But if you like corned beef in a can, then this is a way you can fix it that will probably be a little different from what you're used to. And I think you'll enjoy it. I hope so.